the longer the pause, the more vigilant you need to be.
Yeah.
So a cable's live. The left wing down, but yeah, use your rudder with the stick. Okay, there was a promising cloud over to the right, so why don't you turn back?
Yeah.
Just go and have a little sniff under that cloud. So turn back.
That one there.
Yeah, just head underneath it. There might be something, there might not. But you're not in a bad place for your high key position over here, are we?
No, we've got plenty of space, plenty of rundown. I mean,
so. While we're flying in that direction, obviously 50 knots please, what we'll do is just have a think of a floor below which we will head back and land. So what's that floor?
As in?
Height above the ground, so.
Okay, yeah, that's some 900 feet I think, okay. If we're coming across this way.
Yeah. So we're going to be downwind of the airfield, so at 900 feet, that sounds good to me.
Turn back round left, I think, so coming that way a little
no,
bit.
No, turn right.
You sure? Okay.
The shortest way back to the airfield.
Okay, so we're not really picking too much, and we're pretty much at 900.
Okay, because we're in...
I think we're turned.
We're in lift, we're not going down, we actually gained about 50 foot there, but... nothing's working, so do a turn now to the right. So you've got the height, you can afford to fly back to the airfield a little bit.
Yeah.
Or you can go straight into your downwind leg, which is what I presume you've done.
Yes, okay. But pointing back towards so you can get a bit closer.
So think about your circuit.
Yeah.
Doesn't look as if there's any significant change. The wind maybe has picked up a little bit. But we're still going to land at the same end. No water carried, undercarriage is fixed, no loose objects in the back, my straps are good. How's your straps?
Oh, sorry, yeah, mine are still secure, no loose articles in front.
And no loose articles in the back, and there's no flaps fitted to this aircraft. Okay. So when you judge you're at about the right place to join up your normal downwind leg.
Yeah.
That's good. Okay. So just anticipate that there might be a bit of crosswind.
Yeah.
A bit more perhaps than on the last one. Have a look at your landing area. What does that angle look like?
For me that looks good.
Okay.
But we've still got plenty of height, so I can cover a little bit further. But now is the time to start setting the 60.
Good, well done.
A little bit further out.
Okay, so I don't know if you saw your variometer, but we had a bit of lift then.
I didn't see it, no.
Yeah. So we've committed to land, so the lift means we were a little higher.
Yeah.
Your speed's still, or it is smack on for you, but
it was a bit below, I did see
reducing
that.
A bit. So just think about where you're going to do this. Pretty much normal landing for you.
I'll stay well away from the other glider, so come over to the left and then I'll come in on final knot. So so I'll put it away a little bit. And now it's a bit off. I can support it. Yeah, slide these, put that on the left one. The wings level.
Speed.
Close it a little bit. Yeah.
Well, I have control.
It's going so well.
It's alright, what you needed to do was also close the air brakes at that point. So we were pointing quite low, yeah. The air brake needed to go in. So when I took control, I just moved the air brake forward.
Yeah.
And allowed the glider to accelerate. So our speed wasn't good, but I did prompt you early enough
that I should have done something about it.
To have started picking it up a little bit. It's all ground rush. You know, it happens very close to the ground.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that's why the speed control is so important. So be prepared for it as we get close to the ground because of that wind shear.
Yeah.
Okay. Otherwise, it was very well flown. There's no problems at all with that. That was good. Well done.